वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग ऑफ साइंस लेक्चर ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8. टुडे वी विल सी लेसन नंबर 16, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट. वी गेट डिफरेंट फीलिंग्स थ्रू सेंसेस. द सेंस ऑफ विजन इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट among our five senses, and because of this we can see the hills, rivers, trees, people and objects around us. Only with this we can see the beautiful views of nature like clouds, rainbow, flying birds, moon, stars, etc. Now you try this. You switch off the light in your room at night or sometime and then turn it on again. Could you see the objects in the room clearly when the light was switched off? What did you feel when it was turned on again? Now you can notice that there is some connection between the sense of vision and light. When we switch off the light at night, the objects in the room cannot be seen and they can be seen as before when the light is switched on again. Thus, we can see objects when the light coming from these objects enter our eyes, and the light entering our eyes may be emitted by the object or may be reflected by that object. Now what is meant by light reflected by an object? Now let us learn about the reflection of light. You can see in this picture one torch and one mirror is there. When the light of the torch is falling on the mirror, that time light rays which fall on the mirror get reflected and travel in a different direction. The rays falling on any surface are called incident rays. The point at which an incident ray falls is called the point of incidence. The rays going away from the surface after the reflection are called the reflected rays. And the direction of reflected rays is decided by some rules which are called laws of reflection. Definition of reflection of light. When light rays fall on an object, their direction changes and they turn back. This is called the reflection of light. This is the diagram of reflection of light. Here PQ showing the position of the mirror, and AO means red line, that is the ray AO is the incident ray, and ray OB is reflected ray. And now is the perpendicular to the line position of the mirror, that is PQ at O, and this line means ON. It is called a normal to the mirror. Okay, means AO is the incident ray, OB is the reflected ray, and ON is the normal of the mirror. As ON is perpendicular to PQ, so angle PON is equal to angle QON is equal to 90 degree. Laws of reflection. There are three laws of reflection. First one, the angle of reflection is equal to the angle of incidence. Means the angle of reflection and the angle of incidence is the same. Second, the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal lie in the same plane. Means incident ray, reflected ray and normal. It is lie in the same plane. Third one, the incident ray and the reflected ray are on the opposite side of the normal. We also observed that incident ray and reflected ray, it is the opposite side of the normal. There are two types of reflection. First one, regular reflection of light. Second, irregular reflection of light. First one, regular reflection of light. What will happen when a light ray is incident perpendicular to the mirror? You can observe in this picture. See here, there is one smooth surface, means plane surface is that, and three parallel rays, which are blue, that are the incident rays, and which are red, that are the reflected rays. You can also observe that blue lines and red lines that are parallel, okay, means the reflection of light from a plane at smooth surface is called regular reflection of light. And for regular reflection, the angle of incidence as well as of reflection are the same for all parallel rays falling on the surface, and thus the reflected rays are also parallel to one another. If the angle of incidence for incident rays are, there is given here I and R. So I means incident ray and R means reflected ray. So I1, I2 and I3, and their angles of reflection R1, R2, R3 respectively, then I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3 and R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3. Second one, irregular reflection of light. You can observe in this diagram, there is now rough surface, and you can observe there are blue rays and red rays, means incident ray and reflected rays. Now incident rays and reflected ray, you also observe that they are not parallel to each other because there is the rough surface, okay, and so that are not equal to any rays. Means I1 is not equal to I2, R1 is not equal to R2, as like this. Okay, so reflection of light from a rough surface is called irregular reflection of light. And in regular reflection, the angles of incidence for parallel rays of incidence are not equal, and therefore their angles of reflection are also not equal. I1 is not equal to I2 is not equal to I3, and R1 is not equal to R2 is not equal to R3, and thus the reflected rays are not parallel to one another and spread over a large surface. You always remember, laws of reflection are followed in both regular and irregular reflection. And the reflection of light in irregular reflection has not been obtained because the laws of reflection are not followed. They are obtained because the surface is rough, which means that is irregular. And in regular reflection, the angle of incidence at different points are different. But at any one point, the angles of incidence and reflection are equal. Means I1 is equal to R1 and that. Reflection of reflected light. How do you see if the barber in a saloon has cut the hair on your neck properly or not? In saloon, there are mirrors in your front and back also. The image of the back of your head is formed in the mirror at the back. The image of this image is formed in the mirror in front of you. Thus, you can see how the hair at the back side of your head is cut. And how do you see the image of the moon in water? As moon is not self-luminous, the sunlight falling on the surface of the moon is reflected. This reflected light is again reflected by the water to give us the image of the moon. In this way, light can be reflected several times. For reflection of reflected light, example is kaleidoscope. Here, this is the kaleidoscope. And how you make this kaleidoscope? You take three rectangular mirrors of the same size. And using sticking paper, stick the mirrors together, making a triangle with the reflecting surface facing inwards. And take a white paper of triangular shape and fix it with tape at one end of the mirror, closing that end. And now insert 4 or 5 colored glass pieces in the hollow of the mirrors and close the other end also with a paper and make it a hole in it. And now look through the hole towards light. You will see innumerable images of the glass pieces. These are formed due to reflections by the three mirrors. Okay, you understood? You can see the different designs in the kaleidoscope. And the speciality of a kaleidoscope is that the designs do not easily repeat themselves. It is used to watch different designs. Every time the design is different. People making wallpapers which are used to decorate walls, and cloth designers use kaleidoscope for making new designs. Periscope. This is also reflection of reflected light. How you can make at your home this periscope? You take a cardboard box and make slits in the top and bottom sides of the box and place the two mirrors so that they make an angle of 45 degrees with the sides of the box and are parallel to each other, and fix them with the sticking tape. You can see, you can also observe the figure also. And make two windows of 1 inch each near the two mirrors. Now see through the bottom window as like this and make note of what you see. When you can see from the bottom window, that time one can see what is in front of the top window. Okay, and this is called a periscope. From the bottom window, one can see what is in front of the top window. This device is called a periscope, and this is used in the submarines to see objects above the surface of water. You can see in this picture, this is the submarine and periscope on a submarine. So which device is there on submarines? There's periscope. It is also used to observe the keep and watch the objects or persons on the ground from an underground bunker. Kaleidoscope and periscope both use the properties of reflection of light. So everyone, make the kaleidoscope and periscope at your home. Now I will give the one activity for every student. Everyone, make the kaleidoscope and periscope, and you can also observe that reflection of light.